Whites in Britain today are in a precarious position. Most of our cities and towns are rapidly becoming dangerous occupied territory. They are nothing more than holding pens and slaughterhouses for our people. It's time to face the facts. The methods and tactics employed by racially conscious whites for the past 60 years have been unsuccessful. Democratic politics has not secured a single street's worth of sustainable white living space. Chasing newspaper headlines and hollow temporary victories has not advanced our cause. Instead, we have wasted time, money, and energy chasing our tails and making clever salesmen rich. The time where we could entertain the unlikely hope of being swept into power has passed. Our failed tactics have left us living in our enemy's world, helpless and unable to effect any lasting change. Somehow, nationalists have managed to neglect a fundamental truth of politics. Every successful movement has first carved out a heartland of its own. We need look no further than the early days of the labour movement in Britain to see that resources, energies and activists need to be concentrated in suitable locations with the purpose of laying down roots by shaping communities sympathetic to our views and message. We need to start building a society of our own. It's not too late. Sowing the seeds of our racial survival has to start somewhere. We need to lower our sights and up our game by affecting what we can affect and changing what we are able to change. To stand any chance of survival, we need to pioneer living space where our values and principles become the norm. We are dedicated to creating racially conscious white communities in realistic, sustainable locations. We are starting to build a community of our own. Moving out of multiracial communities and comfort zones into our own target areas is paramount. This marks the difference between the helpless cycle of white flight and exclusive pioneering. Racially conscious whites who continue to inhabit communities populated by ethnic minorities and passive whites are giving their silent approval to their own extinction, as well as propping up anti-white regimes and their economies. Creating our own economy is essential. This means employing our own, buying from our own, and selling to our own. We do not advocate running to the hills or segregating ourselves in some Waco-style compound. These pioneering white communities need to be situated in areas where ease of access to everyday necessities and infrastructure is possible, such as employment, housing, transport, education, healthcare, and other amenities. When looking at potential target areas, we need to pay close attention to demographics and the unavoidable changes which will occur in future. Now that whites are officially the minority in Britain's capital city, other towns and cities in the surrounding regions of England will inevitably follow. When taking into consideration such facts, it is our belief that the best prospects for viable, sustainable, and racially aware communities are to be found in the northeast of England. A recent study in the northeast of England showed that whites there are the most racially conscious in the country. They say the northeast of England is 40 years behind the rest of the country in attitudes towards race. This may be the reason the northeast has seen so many racially aware whites seeking a better quality of life settle in the region. Our racial competitors are winning. They are winning because they have successfully practiced the tactic of community building for a long time. It is time for us to do the same. If you doubt how successful this tactic is, then explore the non-white strongholds of Bradford, Brighton, Birmingham, Leeds, Leicester, and Luton. Building communities and living side by side is not illegal. And because all private property and land remains in the hands of individuals who are simply living their lives within the boundaries of the law, the powers that be are helpless to counteract this anonymous, positive, and leaderless strategy. If we are serious about securing a future for our race in this country, it is time for us to do the same.